I'm sorry about the different intro, but I believe that the referees are still checking if Cristiano Ronaldo is still onside or offside. They are still checking. Still, because they are not sure about it. Jokes aside, ciao Juventini of the world, I hope you are doing well. Welcome back on the channel, my name is Giuseppe. And yesterday, a convincing Juve, 3-0 versus Crotone, Juventus is not dead. We are still in the run for the Scudetto because virtually, if we win versus Napoli, by the way, in the video, we will probably give you a hint when the game will be played again versus Napoli, finally, because we are waiting still October, but virtually, we are at -1 for Milan, the big Milan of Ibrahimovic, and -5. With 15 games to play from Inter, so Juventus is not dead. Before starting and going into the Italian and international papers to see what they are saying about our beloved Juventus, I ask you kindly, I repeat you, to subscribe to the channel. We just passed the 11,300, goal is 12,000, that's our goal, the first step. Don't forget a maximum of like, and we start immediately. Some people were asking me, Giuseppe, are you mentally sick? How do you do it to prefer the Serie A versus the Champions League? It's quite easy because I know the Italian culture. I know all the anti-Juve of the world. Gazzetta front page is scandalous. Because what do you expect to see today after the brace of Cristiano Ronaldo? After the debut of Fagioli, really beautiful debut in Serie A. Do you expect them to see on the Gazzetta dello Sport on the front pages? We see Antonio Conte. Antonio Conte, Inter golosa. What does that mean, Inter golosa? That Inter wants to eat more and more and more. They already put the Italian flag next to Antonio Conte with Fuga Scudetto, the runaway to the Scudetto. They don't care about Juventus. They don't want to win. They don't want to see Juventus win. This is a fact on Gazzetta dello Sport. I remember, for people that doesn't know about it, Gazzetta dello Sport is based in Milan and it's slightly an Inter paper. Do they dedicate some words for Juventus? Yes, because they said Volaldo instead of Ronaldo. Vola, it means flying, because the guy, we will speak about all his personal records. So if you love Cristiano Ronaldo, remain on the channel, guys. Don't forget, put a maximum of like. We go inside. No. We don't go inside because I want to prove again that I want that 10 Scudetto more than everything. I want 10. I want 20. I want 100. I want 1,000. Even when I will pass away from the sky, I want to see Juventus still winning the Serie A. La Juve risorge con il Crotone, ma per lo Scudetto ormai è tardi. Giancarlo Padovan, Italian journalist on Calciomercato, I believe, he wrote that Juventus rise again versus Crotone, but it's too late for the Scudetto. Giancarlo Padovan. Let me know in the comments if you are a Giancarlo Padovan or if you are a Giuseppe Bognami, G-Just Juve. Elvin Wright, la Juventus a disputé ce soir lors de Juve Crotone son 250e match à l'Allianz Stadium. 197 victoires dans ce stade pour les Bianconeri. Juventus, Juventus played 250 games in the Allianz Stadium, 197 games won. This is incredible, incredible. Corriere dello Sport, Juve ci pensa sempre, CR7, Juventus is always Cristiano to think about it, to solve the situation. And yesterday, what a brace of Cristiano Ronaldo, two times with a header. Pirlo rilancia, troppo nervosi, poi Cristiano ci ha sbloccati. He said something totally right. He said, in the beginning of the game, we were too nervous, we were anxious, and it's normal because we come from the loss versus Porto, mentally a trauma, a shock, but after the two braces, the two goals of Cristiano Ronaldo, we were back. What about Tutto Sport? The paper is speaking a lot about Juve that I subscribe to because they deserve it. Tutto Sport, Conte, io non mollo. Conte, train of Inter, I don't give up. And these are also my words, guys. I don't know about you, but I don't give up. Absolutely not, with a great celebration of Cristiano Ronaldo. Tre passi avanti, avanti la Juve non molla. Three steps ahead. Why? Because we were sixth, now we are third. We won the three points. Juventus doesn't give up. CR7 e compagni impegnano da subito cordas fino alla rese. From the beginning, Juventus, Cristiano Ronaldo and his friends, they were dangerous versus cordas, the goalkeeper of Crotone, until Crotone gave up. They gave up because Juventus was too strong yesterday. Some stats to prove it. with Juventus Crotone 3-0, 60% of possession, 40 for them, 26 shots, I saw somewhere 27 shots for, towards the goal. McKennie run 12 kilometers, that's a lot, what a man. CR7 11 shots, Danilo 28 offensive ball played, Demiral 98% of succeeded passes, McKennie and Danilo 7 recuperations of balls, Kulusevski played 48 balls, he played 80 minutes yesterday, and then CR7 7 occasions, 2 goals, he did some misses, we have to be honest with that. Inter, siamo lì. What about Inter, Pirlo said, we don't care, we are there to fight, we don't give up, and now for sure we will have to invent something, because we know that yesterday Danilo had a yellow card, he will not be there versus Verona on Saturday. Vecchio a chi, Ronaldo segna, Buffon insegna, beautiful title by the way by Tutto Sport. Who is old? This is what the title is saying. Ronaldo scores, Buffon is teaching. Yes, because yesterday the goalkeeper that did 654 games in Serie A, it's a record in Europe, he was screaming to the world, to everyone, even at the 91st minute where there was, we were winning 3-0 on a corner kick, he was screaming towards his teammates to pay attention. He was really a big leader on the team. I love his voice. If there is one thing that I love, to the fact that the fans are not at the stadium, there is only one thing, is the fact that you can hear the voice of our leaders, of our players on the field. What about the stats of Cristiano Ronaldo? 78 team that he scored against, that in the 5 big leagues, so this is really a lot, 78 teams, and he scored to all the teams that are actually in Serie A, 18 teams on 18 for Cristiano Ronaldo. We continue with the stat, because yesterday 133rd goal with the header, 133rd goal with the header for Cristiano Ronaldo, BAM! I'm sorry, I feel excited about that. Elvin continue with some stats. 25th goal of the season, all competitions for Cristiano Ronaldo. He's 18th in the season, and he not only equalized 17 goals of Lukaku, but he surpassed them. What a guy. Just, are you happy about the stats of Cristiano Ronaldo? Probably yes, because you love Juve. I am super happy. The GOAT, I don't forget, we sell this t-shirt on Turin's Finest. So, don't forget the link, you click, you buy, and you will be happy. But, not everyone was happy, because if we see the celebration of Cristiano Ronaldo, the man in the back, all in black, I don't know if he was a real Juventino, I don't know. What about the stats of the Juventus, the top scorer all time? We see that Del Piero with 290 goals will still be there on top, what a goat. But Ronaldo is really near to Dybala, 98 goals, player in activity at Juve that can change and can reach really soon the 100 when he will play back, we will speak about Dybala. But Cristiano Ronaldo scored 90 goals all competition with Juventus, and now on Netflix, apparently the documentary about Pele, Rey, the King, came out. I will check it because I'm a football lover, but I'm just asking myself, will the goal that he scores in Netflix also be added to his personal stats? I don't know. Let's see. Beautiful yesterday, Nicolò Fagioli, he said on Instagram, 22 February, a unique emotion. This was my begin in Serie A with the most beautiful shirt that exists. If you already make me fall in love with you, with your abilities, with your skills, but then you write poesy, then I'm really in love with you, with the most beautiful gold shirts of the world. Really beautiful. But then you had a Demiral. Demiral is always on Instagram. He's answering all the world except of me. He was writing, bravo Fagioli, sempre troppo lavori perché tu qualità top, with a basic Italian saying, continue to work really hard because your qualities are really great. We continue with Demiral, because yesterday when they are asking him is the Scudetto race over, he said, I just want to say that we are Juventus and we will talk at the end of the season. So everyone, Gazzetta dello Sport, Giancarlo Padovan, We talk at the end of the season where we will leave the 10th Scudetto in a row. What about Paratici and Dybala for the contract extensions? There were some rumors that they found an agreement. Yesterday, Paratici said the extension of the contract. We are talking, we continue to talk in the next days and in the next months. We will see. Adesso Paolo è sull'altalena. Alcuni giorni sta meglio, altri peggio. At the moment, because he's talking about his injury, some days he feels really well, he's ready to start, and some other days he still feels some pain. So Dybala last minute versus Verona, we will decide if he will be on the bench or not. Rabiot will be back after the suspensions, but this time it's Danilo that will not be there. I told you, and I want to finish with it, about the news about Juve-Napoli that we have to play back, that we are waiting since the 4th of October. We found maybe a day. So if Napoli is disqualified of Europa League, probably there will be a slot free on the 17th of March. A day more on March. Just like that. It's magic. Hopefully we win so that we recuperate these 3 points that we deserve. This was it for me, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. It was a video full of boost because I am super boosted, because they are proving it that the Scudetto race is not over. Grazie a tutte. Don't forget to put the maximum of like. Subscribe to the channel. It's really easy. Thank you, Forza. Juve.